So I'm back home now, back home for the weekend from university. For those of you that don't know, I'm at the University of Bath. I've done my A-levels, done my GCSEs, and I've got loads of good grades in it. Hence why I started making videos on GCSE and A-level content in this room. Yeah, we are back in the OG room. So I thought, as I'm here, I may as well crack out all of the rest of the A-level content that you guys have been after. So today's video, I'm gonna be basically explaining how I got an A-star in physics and exactly how you can get there too in as easy and as efficient a form as possible. I'm also gonna be dropping one later in this week on A-level maths. So that'll complete the trilogy of maths, physics, and chemistry that I did. I also did further maths, but the same logic applies for the maths. And yeah, then on that channel, I'll basically have all of the GCSE content, so how to get nines in all of those subjects, how to get A stars in all of the A-level subjects, and then all of the university vlogs that basically just try to inspire you to do as much as you can, to live as best life as you can, and get all of the experiences that you want while still smashing out the work. So if that sounds like content you want to watch, I definitely drop a subscribe. Otherwise, recently there's been so much hype about the metaverse, and the metaverse is mad, but what I'm more hyped about is the fact that if you drop a like on this video, you actually triple your chances of getting the grades you want. And yeah, I wouldn't take that risk. Without further ado, let's crack on with the video. Oh, and this video is also sponsored by Stat Revise, but there's more on that at the end. Okay, so there's essentially three key aspects of my revision method. There's preparation, there's review, and then there's past papers. Now, what I mean by this is the preparation phase is basically converting all of the knowledge that you have into short, easy to use resources that you can help to review the content. For me, that's cue cards, both physical and digital. But for A-level, I actually did physical cue cards, and then towards the end, digital. I would recommend going digital, but everything I'm about to explain applies for physical or digital. So, in this phase, these books are pretty essential. Now, it doesn't actually matter whether you get the revision guide or whether you get the actual textbooks. I got the textbooks for physics and the revision guide for chemistry, but that's only because I liked the physics more, so I was happy to read more of it. You get the same thing with the revision guides. So if you just want to be as efficient as possible, buy the CGP physics revision guide. I'll link it in the description below. It absolutely slaps and just does wonders. But essentially what you're going to do is, if you're starting off your course now, whenever you finish a chapter, make cue cards on all of the content in the chapter. Or if, for example, you're in year 13 and need to catch up, just start working your way through that textbook, making cue cards on each of those chapters. That is all you need to do for the preparation phase. And if you actually want to watch a video on exactly how I make my cue cards and how I use them to be most effective, that video is up there. But these cue cards form the framework of your revision. It's essentially just an easy way to remind yourself of the information and the understanding that you had when you first learned the topic. Because after a lot of time, you tend to forget the content and forget that understanding. But because you've already learned it before, you just need a stimulation to remind yourself of that content or of that understanding. That is what cue cards are used for, and I explain that more in my cue card video, but that is the preparation phase. Then the second aspect of that revision is review. And now why review? I literally just mean going through all of those cue cards, making sure you know all of the information, and any cue cards you don't quite understand, put to one side. Any cards you do understand, put to another side, and then just keep going through the ones you don't understand until it clicks. And just set aside time running up to the exams to actually review those cue cards, because there's no point in making them. Well, there is some point because it's still going to be beneficial, but there's no real value in making them if you're not going to review them. The first aspect is preparation. That's actually making those resources. The second aspect is review, actually going through those resources and helping to convert all of that information and understanding into your long-term memory, so that when you get into the exam, you actually have some clue as to what you're doing and you can get a decent mark. Okay, and then the final phase, I mean, you probably guessed that it was coming, but the final phase is practice papers. Practice papers are a godsend, and it's one of the most effective ways to revise the content. Essentially, you just set aside time to work your way through papers, then you'll mark the entire paper, and any questions you got wrong, you'll write a cue card on it, adding to that pile of cue cards that you're using to review. And essentially, the value here is you start to learn the exam technique. And if you get a question wrong that you have fundamental understanding of the content for, but just don't get the answer right because of exam technique, you'll write that on the cue card. And when you're reviewing those cue cards, you'll get it into your mind not to write it in the way that you did, but to write it so that you actually get marks in the exam. So you can now see that the three phases are kind of linked. You start by making cue cards on all of the content. You review that content so you can hit past papers. And then you use those past papers to understand the exam technique, to make more cue cards for more review, and then just keep cycling through that process. And that is exactly what I did to get an A star in my physics. Physics is a very straightforward subject. Once you get your head around the concepts, it's just about learning the information and then getting the exam technique down. Once you've got that, you're absolutely sorted. But if you don't think you have time to go through all of this, that's where Snap Revise comes in. The story of Snap Revise is actually pretty crazy, because since using them and plugging them in one of my first ever videos, which was that video, they've actually become quite a long-term sponsor of this channel. And honestly, their resources have been so helpful for me. So there's three resources that they have. They have the Snap Revise cheat sheets, which basically just condense the entire entire A-level curriculum into like 20 summary sheets, and you can use those to work through instead of having a big hefty textbook or revision guide like this. That was an absolute lifesaver, and on top of everything that I did, I also used those to review like my fundamental understanding, or as like a quick checklist of all of the information. So those you can download in the description below. But then the second product, and this is probably the most helpful for saving time, but they've actually condensed the entire course into just 200 cue cards based on the exam specification. So let's bust them open. So this is what you get in the box. You get a contents page that tells you what is on every single one of those 200 cards. So if you want to skip forward to a particular topic, you can do just that, which honestly is going to be super helpful, especially when you're just looking for one particular idea. And typically you'd have to search through all of the cue cards that you've made to try and find that one idea. That is really helpful. But essentially on the front, you just have a summary of all of the information. And then on the back, you actually have exam questions. These questions are never seen anywhere other than Snap Revise, because Snap Revise writes them based on the exam specification. For example, with the absorption spectra, you've got information about the absorption spectra and then a question on the back, so you can cover up the answer, work your way through the question, see if you get it right, and if not, just repeat that process of creating either physical or digital cue cards to help with that stage of review. Essentially what these cue cards are going to do is they're going to bypass that stage of preparation, allow you to go straight into review and actually have exam questions or past papers within those cue cards. So all three phrases are actually wrapped up in these cue cards, but obviously you can do additional work on top of that to make sure that you get the grades and keep cycling through those three aspects of revision. And then there's the course.
Okay, so the course is basically just the complete package and can be used to teach everything you need to know or can just be used as revision. You work your way through all of the topics by first taking a quiz on each. This quiz determines the subtopics you struggle on and then highlights those topics in orange for review. You then review each with the bite-sized videos before attempting a new quiz, continuing this cycle until you've mastered every subtopic. Then, for each, there is also a set of exam questions for additional practice, making sure that you absolutely smash the exam.
Okay, so if you do want to check any of those resources out, just hit the top link in my description below, and you can also use the code SnapRevisedJake for a free 14-day subscription to both the basic and the pro subscriptions of that SnapRevised course. But otherwise, that is it for me today, so I do hope you have enjoyed. If you have, I would absolutely love it if you dropped a subscribe. I've got bags more content like this coming. In fact, I've got the maths one coming this Friday, and then all of the university vlogs, well, pretty indefinitely, to be honest. But yeah, I hope you did enjoy, and I'll see you in the next one. I live inside my own world of make-believe.